Myositis is an inflammatory disease of the muscles. In rheumatology, we talk about dermatomyositis when both the skin and the muscles are involved, and we talk about polymyositis when only the muscles are involved. There are also other types of myositis, but in this video, I will discuss the most common signs and symptoms of dermatomyositis and polymyositis.
Rheumatologistoncall.com.
Muscle weakness. The patients will describe proximal muscle weakness involving the upper part of the arms and legs. The weakness is gradual, usually over the course of a few months, and it can involve the shoulders and pelvic area. Patients will describe getting quickly tired when they comb their hair or wash their hair in the shower and when they use their arms for a repetitive action. They will have difficulties getting out of the chair or from their car. They will have to push themselves out. Most of the time, they don't have too much pain, but they feel weak. Rarely, the disease can involve the neck muscles that will cause changes in the voice and difficulties swallowing the food. If you have these signs, they are indicative of a more severe disease. Skin changes. There are many skin changes in dermatomyositis, where most of the time, both the skin and the muscles are affected. However, there are some variants of dermatomyositis that have no muscle involvement. Heliotrope rash. This is a purple rash affecting the eyelids, the malar region, the forehead, and nasolabial folds. Gotron papules. Those are purple to red, flat, or raised lesions that can happen on the back of your metacarpal joints. It can also happen over the elbows and over the knees. V-sign rash. This type of rash is located on the anterior chest and can look like a V-sign. Scholl sign rash. This is a rash over the shoulders and the upper part of the arms that sits there like a shawl. Holster sign. This is a rash on the lateral aspects of the proximal thighs. Mechanic's hands. These are cracking and fissuring of the finger pads, especially the index finger. And it is more commonly seen in patients with polymyositis than dermatomyositis. Nail changes. There are some rashes around the nails that we call periangular erythema, sometimes accompanied by cuticular overgrowth. If we look with a magnifier and we add a drop of immersion oil, we can see a lot of dilated capillaries. Subcutaneous calcifications. These are seen over the elbows, but sometimes over the knees and in other parts of the body. These changes are more frequently seen in patients that have dermatomyositis, especially in children. Elevated muscle enzymes. This is an essential laboratory test when we suspect an inflammatory muscle disease. The test is called creatine kinase, or CPK, or creatine phosphokinase. This test is elevated almost in all patients with dermatomyositis or polymyositis. We can get other laboratory tests like aldolase, myoglobin, LDH, AST, ALT, and remember these two are liver enzymes also. These tests are elevated in most patients with active inflammatory muscle disease. I hope this short video was very helpful to you. Remember to subscribe and learn more. If you have an autoimmune disease and if you need help, you are welcome to check out our practice and get the help that you need when you need it the most. Rheumatologist on Call is a telemedicine rheumatology practice that broadens the access to a specialist in a very short time when you need it the most. And it breaks the geographical barriers. Check out the states where we are licensed to see patients in the US and reach out to us if needed. We are very happy to serve you. Don't forget to subscribe and learn more about arthritis and autoimmune diseases. And also please share the channel with people that will benefit from these educational lectures. Have a wonderful day and thank you.
RheumatologistOnCall.com